Hello dear students, good morning everyone. Today we are going to study a new lesson in civics, that is lesson number 9, public facilities. Here in this lesson we are going to study what is public facilities, why these public facilities are provided. In this lesson it starts with the water shortage problem in Chennai. As we can see, different people, they face water shortage in Chennai. People from some rich area in Chennai, they face water shortage and they purchase water at different cost. Same way, people from yet another place in Chennai, they face water shortage and they also get or they purchase water from outside and by paying money. So this is common in Chennai. About this case study, the stories of different people, it is given in the textbook. As we can see, the Anna Nagar, one place where people face problem. Same way, Mylapore, another place in Chennai, people face water shortage. Madipakkam, another place in Chennai, they also face problem of water. And Padma, who works a domestic help, works as a domestic help in Saidapet, she also face water shortage. And every these people get water from various sources or they purchase water. So water is very important basic necessity of human being. Water as a part of the fundamental right to life. And what in Chennai people spent rupees 500 to 650 per month to buy water from the tankers. Some people they use borewell water, which is not good in quality, but still they depend upon the borewell water. So these are the different problems people face in Chennai. Through this we can understand that why public facilities are needed, or water is one of the important necessity, and where the role of government to provide water is very important. Next slide we can see right to water. So in our Constitution of India, which recognizes the right to water as being part of right to life under Article 21. So Constitution of India recognizes the right to water as important part of right to life under the Article 21. It means that every people, whether rich or poor, to have sufficient amount of water to fulfill his or her basic needs at a price that he or she can afford. It means that right to water states that every people, rich or poor, they can access water or they can fulfill their water need by the price, at a minimum price or at a price which is affordable for everyone. So this is known as universal access to water. So it is affordable for every rich and poor people, then it is known as universal access to water. Next slide shows that what are public facilities. We can see that the facilities which are essential that should be governed, that should be provided by the government. And we can see various such basic facilities are provided by the government. In our surrounding, if we see water which is provided by the municipality, which is a government organization or government organ. Again, electricity provided by the government. Government schools are in various parts, we could see that is also provided by the government. Many colleges are also established, which is under government. Health facilities, public means health dispensaries or health facilities like hospitals, medical colleges, these all are given or it is established, these all are given to the people. public transport, like transport system, buses, trains, which are also provided by the government. So here we can see these all needs or all facilities which are provided by the government, it is known as public facilities. Once these facilities are provided, its benefits can be shared by many people. So once it is provided, we can see every people, even rich people and poor people, they can get the benefits. For example, a school in a village area, which its use or its utility can be shared, or its benefits can be shared by many students of that area. Rich people also can go to that school, and even poor students also can depend on that school. So same way, supply of electricity to one area, it can be useful to many people. So the aim of public facilities is that its benefits can be shared by many people. What is the government's role in providing public facilities? Government's role in providing public facilities, we can see that government ensure, or government make it sure that these facilities are made available to everyone. Whether everybody is getting water, whether everybody is getting electricity, whether everybody is getting transport facilities, whether everybody is getting education, these all ensuring or to make a survey, or government make it sure that these facilities are available to everyone. And the aim of the public facilities is to maximize the welfare of the people. Second thing, that government provide the public facilities in order to give the welfare of the people. Welfare of the people means that the people, what they want, whatever basic needs people want, that is given by the government, not depending on the profit, but depending upon the but they judge or they make it avail to the people. The prices of the public facilities are affordable to everyone. Electricity is provided to everyone, and its cost in its prices are affordable to everyone. How much they consume or how much they use, according to that, minimum charges are taken or collected by the government from the people. So prices of these public facilities are affordable to everyone. If we go by a public bus or a government bus, the ticket charge is affordable to everyone. That is the aim of this public facility, is to maximize the welfare of the people and to ensure that everybody is getting it or not. And it relate to the people's basic needs. So government, which or the public facilities which relate or which relate or to the basic needs of the people. So the basic needs such as water, health, electricity, food, these all are given by the government. These all facilities we can say as public facilities. But we could see the private facilities, or the facilities which are provided by some companies or by a group of individuals or an individual. It is known as private facility, or it is under one company or one of the organization which is not government. So it is known as private facilities. But here we could see the aim of the private facility is to maximize profit. In public facilities, we have seen the aim is to maximize the welfare of the people. But here it is maximize profit. Only one section of the society, that is rich, can afford it. So here we can see only one section of society can afford it. That is the difference between private facilities and public facilities.